why don't we know what's underneath our feet? We've been to the moon. We've been to Mars. Our probes have gone past Jupiter. How come we don't know what's at the center of the Earth?
Our historic understanding of the Earth's inner core has been called into question by a group of scientists after analyzing recent earthquake data. A shocking new development has been observed that has attracted the attention of the entire scientific community, including veterans like Michio Kaku and Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Orbit beyond the blue.
People have been talking about Earth's core lately. It's been in the news.
The Earth's inner core is a solid spheroid. It is approximately 5,200 degrees Celsius. It generates its own magnetic field. It is not connected to the other layers of Earth. It has a radius of 1220 kilometers. We know very little about the core, but what we do know is that the core is molten iron, the motion of which generates our magnetic field. Without the magnetic field, our atmosphere and oceans would be blasted away by radiation of charged particles from the sun. We would be as dead as Mars. So yes, we got to thank the inner core for being the center of life on Earth. But is something weird going on thousands of kilometers beneath your feet?
The bad news is that we know very little about the core of the Earth, very little about what's underneath our feet. The good news is, probably there's nothing to worry about.
Yes. Seismologists from the Australian National University believe they have found evidence of a previously unknown structure deep within the Earth's inner core. This structure looks like a solid metallic ball and is now being called the innermost inner core by scientists.
And we used to think there were four layers, like the crust and the mantle, four layers inside the Earth. Recently, we picked up evidence of a fifth layer at the very center of the Earth. So we're now basically sonogramming the Earth.
Findings uncovered by the researchers confirmed there are five layers to the Earth's core and not four as was previously thought. This inner core is believed to be a time capsule of Earth's evolutionary history, a fossilized record that serves as a gateway into the events of our planet's past. Events that happened on Earth hundreds of millions to billions of years ago could be traced now. The existence of an internal metallic ball within the inner core, the innermost inner core, was hypothesized about 20 years ago, said Dr. Tarnison Pham from the ANU Research School of Earth Sciences. Many unanswered questions about the Earth's innermost inner core still remain that will require the seismologists to conduct more analysis and research. Many scientists think that the Earth's inner core spins faster than the planet. However, in the past few years that has changed. The Earth's core has apparently stopped spinning. Geologists have studied the dynamics of Earth's guts and have just discovered that Earth's solid inner iron core, which usually spins within a near frictionless molten outer envelope, appears to have slowed to a grinding halt. Well, that's what most of them are saying, but it is nowhere close to the truth. What the new study actually suggests is that the Earth's inner core, which spins independently of the rest of Earth, slowed down, and the core slows down and then speeds up on a regular cycle. The Earth's inner core is a ball of solid iron about as hot as the surface of the sun. It's surrounded by a layer of liquid metal called the outer core. This layer of liquid metal separates the inner core from the rest of the planet, making it possible for the core to rotate at a different speed than the surface. And the recent study that has sent many panicking was published in Nature Geoscience on January 23, 2023. By two scientists from Peking University in China. They used past earthquake data to find that the Earth's inner core was rotating faster than the Earth's surface, but has since slowed to the point of matching the surface's rotation speed. They believe that the core will now begin to rotate slower than the surface, and that the core's rotation speed changes on a 70-year cycle. The inner core rotates faster than the Earth's surface for about half the cycle, and slower during the other half. while the inner core is transitioning between its faster and slower faces. The inner core rotates at about the same speed as the rest of the Earth. The core pausing or turning back, terms used in the study's abstract, refers to the core's position relative to a point on the surface, which is constantly rotating. If you stand on a dot on the Earth's surface, and you put a spot on the inner core directly beneath you, the spot will remain directly beneath you as long as the surface and the core rotate at the same speed. If the core rotates faster than the surface, the spot will move ahead of you. And if the core rotates slower than the surface, the spot will fall behind you. It will look like the spot reversed direction even though it's still rotating the same way, just slower. But why is this so important? Why has this sent the whole world into a frenzy? Scientists believe that the change in the inner core speed could explain changes to the Earth's magnetic field, cause the long-term movement of the magnetic poles, or contribute to minor variations in the length of a day. But all of these are just assumptions about the behavior of the inner core. And since we cannot see the inner core, we use seismic waves from earthquakes to learn about it. That was how Earth's solid inner core was discovered in 1936. Scientists have since used similar methods to build and refine descriptions of the inner core's behavior. Still, many questions remain, such as how to reconcile the slow pace of the changes that the scientists have reported, which seems contrasting when compared with some of the faster changes reported by others. The only way out of the morass is to wait for more earthquakes to happen, but what do I know? Let me tell you a bizarre anecdote about the recent visitor to our solar system, the Green Comet. By now, you must know about this exotic comet. If you don't, then all you need to know is that it is an icy body that orbits our Sun once every 50,000 years. The last time it was spotted from Earth was probably in the Stone Age. It is believed to have come from the Oort cloud, a collection of icy bodies, believed to exist in the farthest flung part of the solar system. While a lot of us were satisfied with this piece of information, there was this one guy who claimed the far-flung comet to be some sort of accursed biological meatball that is giving out meat smoke. That is insane, isn't it? Take a good look at this email that he sent to Timothy Schmidt, a chemistry professor at the University of New South Wales. The gassing off is meat smoke that did not combust and simply vaporizes in sunlight. Metals are from the blood vessels, and the big one is from the artery, said the guy who is also a YouTuber. Now, if you are wondering where am I getting at with this story, what if I tell you that, as disturbing as it sounds, something like this might be true? What if we are being too ignorant by looking for alien life just out there in the vast universe? And what if we can find intelligent life here on planet Earth? Decades ago, the idea of life beyond Earth burst into existence. As the years passed by, the idea picked up, and the hunt for aliens kicked off, and never stopped. The developing technology just worked right in our favor, as we started building insane rovers, telescopes, and other equipment that started hounding the solar system and discovering galaxies, hoping to stumble upon alien life. As I speak, NASA and ESA are planning to build space telescopes that will be tasked with investigating exoplanets for Earth-like conditions. And scientists are also working towards incorporating AI in the hunt for extraterrestrial life on our red neighboring planet. Right from strange, cigar-shaped flying object spotting in multiple locations, to a spooky object sending repeated radio signals from just 4,000 light years away from Earth, there have been instances before when we have come freakishly close to making the first contact. But nothing led to a shred of strong evidence, and just ended up adding to unanswered questions. Just so you know, some are saying that intelligent life has already appeared on planet Earth. One of them is Tomonori Totani, an astronomer at the University of Tokyo. He has worked on a research paper that proposes, instead of focusing on the hunt for alien life outside our solar system, the ideal way is to look into the tiniest traces of our home planet, Earth. Many people now consider astronomical observations of exoplanet atmospheres, but I am impatient about this, because we cannot get a direct sample, and it is difficult to prove the existence of life by remote observation, says Totani. He simply believes that without a tangible piece of evidence from the exoplanet itself, proving the existence of extraterrestrial life is like finding a needle in a haystack. When an asteroid hits a planet, it emits huge quantities of rock from the ground. A good chunk of it will eventually turn back to the surface, or enter a comparatively stable orbit. And about a tenth will ultimately be thrown out of the solar system altogether. Totani's paper proposes that when asteroids or meteorites hit Earth, apart from carrying a load of rocks and metals, they also carry fossilized aliens that are hiding and blending with other particles with their negligible appearance. You need to make a note that it heavily depends on a whole lot of luck for that tiny fossilized passenger. It would have to keep away from being ground or melted by the high impact, or falling back to its home planet, or being thrown away by a combination of gravity and solar radiative pressure. And, most importantly, not to be destroyed in the long interstellar journey. After all this hell of travel, when it finally reaches our solar system, it would have to avoid plummeting into the sun, and then arrive on Earth. One factor that works in the favor of the tiny fossilized traveler is size. Since it is small enough, it can enter the Earth's atmosphere without being severely heated. However, past studies of interstellar panspermia have found it exceptionally unlikely that any life could survive the long journey, grains of rock about 1 micron across. That takes me to our next point of discussion. How realistic is Totani's proposal? Let's try to break it down. Even though there are several layers of uncertain possibilities, Totani gauges that, every year, about 100,000 micron-sized grains from exoplanets land on Earth's surface. These 100,000 grains from other worlds add up to Earth's existing millions of sand grains and get scattered across the globe. Just so you know, the grains coming from exoplanets are 1/100th the size of a grain of sand. That is unimaginably overwhelming for the researchers. In 2019, an international team of researchers was able to filter some interstellar dust from half a ton of snow in Antarctica. Imagine finding the grains from exoplanets. It would be a whole different search within that search. Let's look at another instance from 2013, when researchers announced they had hunted 7 grains of interstellar dust in the sample brought back to Earth by NASA's 2004 Stardust mission. But all this does not influence Totani. I believe, by future technological developments, we will be able to collect grains from outside the solar system, which is by far a tiny amount compared with interplanetary dust, he says. If Totani somehow does not convince you through his research, nothing changes the fact that scientists are constantly in pursuit of alien life. And, as the coming years unfold, any effort might work that will make the first contact, even the one that Totani believes in. Amid all these efforts, aliens have always been a hot topic, especially for science fiction enthusiasts, and all thanks to the movies, we also have a freaky-looking image of an alien in our minds. Imagine you fall asleep to your favorite alien movie, and wake up to the news of an alien found lurking under the deep ocean. What will be your first impression? Scared? Confused? or excited. Let's count on all the ongoing efforts to know the answer. As we speak, you might get the news real soon. But what do I know?
Beyond the blue.